Okay, before you learn from me, the first thing you need to change is the microscope light, okay? If you haven't bought any microscope light, it's best you choose the one I'm using, okay? So now I'll show you what's the difference. Okay, the traditional light is usually on a booth, okay? I don't suggest you to use the kind of that big one, that one is some kind of UFO, okay? That one will block you a lot of things, okay? Let's say you are taking power IC or something, you know, okay? If you use that kind of light, you see, it will blocking a lot, okay? Blocking your A blower. So if you have this kind of light or this type, okay, you can completely almost go straight to do the job, okay? This is very important, okay? If you don't have this kind of light, then it's best you don't join my course at all, okay? Or don't even follow my method. Okay, my method of removing the IC or components is very, very precise, okay? So you need to have a lot of space in the microscope area, okay? So now I show you what's the difference between this kind of light and this kind of light, okay? So I turn on the traditional one, okay? So as you can see, it is very bright, okay, for sure. And the problem is, let's say if I look at this IC, you don't see any dust at all. It's quite difficult to see because of the refraction, okay? And because of the refraction, you can't even see the packs, which one is you can't even see the details of the solder packs, you know. Okay, let's say this is the flat one and this is the bowl one. Okay, it's kind of hard to notice at all. So it's missing a lot of details because of the refraction. Okay, and one more thing is about the color. Okay, because you can't tell between the capacitor color. Sometimes the color is a little wider than this one, it might be have a problem, you know. By looking at this, I can already notice some of the details, you know. Okay, this is a very important thing, that why I don't use this kind of light, even it is very small, okay, even it is not blocking my blower. So now I'm switching to the one I'm using. So turning this off, turn it on. Okay, so this is the one I'm using. You can see there's a lot of details, okay, and you can also notice the packs, okay. So the difference between these packs and this pack and this pack, okay, you will know the difference, okay. This one is kind of like flat, and you can see there's a dot, the particle things here, okay, and also the capacitor color, okay, between these two, okay, they are for different voltage capacitor. Okay, a lot of details you can notice in with this kind of light. Okay, this is why not only the microscope quality will affect the picture quality, you know, the lighting also very important. Okay, and this is so far is the best light I ever use, okay. And by the way, it's best you buy the same type as me, okay? You might be able to find the same design, but eventually the temperature of the light is different, okay? So I might share some link below my YouTube description there, okay? You just look at the link. So it's best you buy the same type, okay? I prefer the one is about 7000K, okay, the temperature, okay. If it come with a little blue, okay, as you can see, I can immediately to see the text that in the audio IC, okay. Okay, let's turn this off and then I turn the normal light on, okay. So even you are using the Olympus or the better microscope, if you don't have a good light, it will be sucks like this, okay? And if you have discount, like be sure you get this kind of things, okay? This is the adapter, okay? Come with the glass. Because when we are doing the soldering, there's some flux and smoke will going up, okay? It will reduce your quality of your microscope, you know. Some of the things cannot be clean, okay? So you need to protect your microscope very well. And by the way, a lot of people are asking what type of microscope I'm using, okay? The one I'm using is this brand, okay? This is kind of like, I only know the Chinese name, but the English name, then the logo is like this. So it say SDP or SOP, I don't know, maybe it's SOP top, okay? The Chinese name is called 舜宇, okay? This quality, this brand is very, very good. They have a high quality internal parts, okay? The quality is almost same as the M scope that in the Western country, right? And some of the component inside, they are using the Olympus part. So this is why when you see my video, it's kind of like really, really nice, you know? Okay, one more thing is the why I still leaving this table into here instead of using that kind of blue tablet, okay, like blue desk or things like this, okay. There's a reason. Let me make an example for you. If I do the CPU or NAND or whatever things, okay, let's say if I want to remove this, okay. You notice my hand, okay, the height of my hand. If you're doing in the lower place like this, okay, your hand need to be really stressed and you need to press down in order to make it as level as possible, you know. If you open the CPU like this, there's a possibility you might damage the CPU. Okay, some of the area in the CPU that is not melted, the packs might easily to be broken. So that's why very importantly you have a things like this to make it higher, and then so then you can maintain the height easily, okay? Okay, not like this. And the second benefit is, well, when I do the cleaning, I can do on here, or either make the blade as flat as possible, okay? I don't need to go other place. Normally, when you buy the microscope, it doesn't come with the glass like this, you know. They come with a plastic, so you can change it to other things, you know. I saw they're selling some kind of black fiber or other things, okay? You can change it with that kind of things. Okay. By leaving the table like this, your hand can be very precise when you're doing the job, you know. Just like the sniper, you know, you have a holder to hold your guns. You can be very precise to keep the strength of your blade or your tip, okay? If you do this low, maybe it's a habit, you know. It's very easy to get tired. This is your step number one, okay?